Hi, I'm Chris White, sports editor of OnlineAthens.com and the Athens Banner-Herald, and this is Georgia beat writer Marc Weiszer. Marc, we're here. Georgia just defeated Georgia Southern 45-14. The scoreboard looks like a big victory at the end. The first half was kind of tight, though. The two teams went to halftime, Georgia leading 17-7. And that was really kind of thanks to a late drive by Georgia to score and a penalty down at this end of the field on Georgia Southern, keeping them out of the end zone. Talk about that first half. I mean, how tight was that? Was that a little scary, do you think, for Georgia, going into the locker room with a score 17-7?
Yeah, I mean, not as scary as it would have been if Georgia Southern had punched that in and, you know, they didn't have the chop block there. They pushed them back. They had attempt a field goal, and they missed it, and Georgia went down, scored the touchdown, 10-point lead. They made some adjustments in the second half and just really got going in the passing game. Murray just lit them up. The secondary had some really favorable matchups, and before you knew it, it was the route that you probably expected.
What about defensively? There was a lot of talk the week coming into this about adjusting the triple option. They're going to this week against Georgia Southern, next week against Georgia Tech. How did the defense adjust to that? And it seems like they did a pretty strong job of keeping Georgia Southern off the board, especially in the second half.
Yeah, I mean, they had a bunch of, a couple three and outs right to start the third quarter. And, really basically into 3-4 minutes into the fourth quarter, Georgia Southern really wasn't getting anything offensively. One of the keys was first down. In the second quarter, or actually in the first half in general, I think it was somewhere like 5.5 yards on first downs that Georgia Southern was making. And in the second half, Georgia was getting some tackles for losses. They were really catching up with what Georgia Southern was doing. And, the week of practice with the cut blocks, I think, definitely paid off. Jarvis Jones was telling me after the game that he got cut a lot more in practice than he actually did out in the field today. Now, there was that big chop block penalty, as we mentioned, that hurt him, but Georgia seemed to fend off those cut blocks pretty well.
Yeah, and the players seemed to think that this was good preparation for next week for Georgia Tech. I know Coach Rick said they're not a carbon copy of what Georgia Southern was doing today, but the players seem confident about how they played today and how that might translate next week.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's definitely obviously a bigger help than playing a Coastal Carolina or a Furman or someone that doesn't run the triple option. But, there's going to be some changes or some differences that you'll see from Georgia Tech. Grantham said that Georgia Southern threw out some stuff early that was a little unusual, that they hadn't seen that much on film. And Georgia Tech's going to have probably better talent at certain skill positions. They have Lee, their quarterback, just helped them a lot against North Carolina with a 60-some point game. And you'll see Georgia Tech, although their defense has had a lot of issues, their offense seemed to be playing better recently. So it would be another test for Georgia, but they got to like the momentum they have from how they did against this defense today.
Again, I'm Chris White, sports editor of the Athens Banner-Herald and OnlineAthens.com. This is Georgia beat writer Marc Weiszer. You can find all of our stuff at OnlineAthens.com and DogBitesOnline.com. Thanks.